Hi, family. Good evening. Welcome. Welcome to tonight's prayer. God bless you. My name is Faith. This is Joy in Zoe Intercession Ministries. We meet here every Monday to Friday from 9 p.m. to 9 p.m. to stand in the gap and intercede for the unreached and the unsaved across the nations. You're welcome to tonight's prayer. God bless you. We are glad that you are here today. I hope you had a wonderful day. I hope you had a blessed day. Thank you. Thank you for joining us tonight. All right. So tonight we'll be praying for the Bushi people in Mayotte. Okay, we are praying for the Bushi people in Mayotte. Alright, so these people, before we begin to pray for this people group tonight, let's commit tonight's prayer into the hands of the Lord. Let's bless him and thank him for the grace to be here tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. And so, Father, we worship you, we bless your holy name, we give you all the praise, we give you thanks and adoration in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Abba, for the grace and the privilege to be here again tonight, to stand in the gap to intercede for the unreached and the unsaved. Lord, we say thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. We ask, O God, that you empower us by your Spirit, Lord, for the Spirit of grace and supplication. Empower us tonight, O God, to pray your will, to pray your kingdom come in the name of Jesus. Amen. We ask that as we join our faith to pray tonight, let your word get to these people speedily. Cause our prayers to be effective, Lord, to the salvation of the souls of this people group. That tonight, to go by the reason of our prayers, Lord, and by the move of the Holy Spirit, many from this people group will come to know of your Son Jesus Christ. They will accept him as the Lord and Savior and be saved to the glory of your name in the name of Jesus. Amen. Holy Spirit, take charge of our prayers tonight. Father, we thank you in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. All right, family. So thank you for joining us today. So for everyone joining us for the first time, you are welcome. We see you and we are glad that you are joining us today. So before we begin, we're going to
Mayotte.
Before we begin our prayers tonight, we're going to tell you a brief about the unreached people so that you will know why we are praying for those people. You will know the reason why we do this and why it is important for us to stand in the gap and pray for the unreached people. All right, so the unreached people, who are they? These are people, ethnic group of people who have no access to the gospel, who do not know about Christ, who have never heard about him, or even if they have heard about him, they do not believe in him, they do not believe in Jesus as the Messiah or as the Son of God or as one who has come to, you know, save mankind. They do not know anything about Christ. Many of those people group do not have churches around them, and there are no Christians among them. And even if they have Christians among them, the number of Christians they have are very little and not enough to evangelize the whole of their community, to get the gospel across their whole ethnic group. So they will always need outside help. They will need missionaries, evangelists, people from outside to come join the few among them, or even come for the first time to spread the word of the Lord, to teach the people about Christ. Now, our duty here in Join Zoe is to pray for those people, this people group who are yet to receive the word of the Lord, is to pray for them so that when the word of the Lord gets to them, their hearts will be ready, will be open to receive the word. They will be able to have faith enough to believe in the word of the Lord, to believe in Jesus and to accept him as the Lord and Savior. Also to pray for the missionaries so that they will have easy access into this community, so that the gates of this ethnic groups of these communities will be open to them and they can reach those people with the gospel. So this is why we are praying for them. And you also know it is our duty as believers to do this. because we have been commanded from scriptures in Matthew 28, from verse 19 to 20, to go into the world and preach the gospel to every ethnic group, you know, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them everything that Christ has commanded us. So this is what we see as the Great Commission, and this is our duty as believers. So this is why we do this. I hope you are excited. I hope you were glad that you were here today. All right, so join us as we pray for tonight's people group. God bless you. So now, the Bushi in Mayotte, this people group, they have a population of 87,000 and a world population of 90,300. They speak the Bushi language and their primary religion is Islam. They have 0.0% Christian adherents and 0.0% evangelical. This is to say, there are no known professing Christians among those people, and there are no known evangelical, which is believers, true Christians, among those people. So they have 0.0% of professing Christians and believers among those people. So the Bushi, there are no known translation of the Bible in the Bushi language. So there is need for the translation of the Bible in the Bushi language, so those people can have access to the word of the Lord in their own language. They have no access to online New Testament. They have no access to the Jesus film. They have no access to audio recordings, and their status is still unreached. Now, those people, the Bushi people of Mayotte, originated on the nearby island of Madagascar. They moved to Mayotte Island in the later half of the 19th century, and these immigrants and plantation workers still live there today. The older generations live according to the traditional ways, such as following the Islamic calendar and structuring their day around the five daily prayer times. The younger generation, who have been educated in the French secular system, now question some of their group traditions and seek the things of the West, such as material wealth, less strict moral codes, and a different manner of dress. Nevertheless, they proudly identify as Islamic. Most of them, however, still look more to spirits to help them with everyday needs or crisis. So the ministry obstacle, the hindrance of the gospel to those people, is that the Bushi identify as Muslim, and to change one's religion is to change one's identity, which is painful, especially in a culture that focuses on the group. So, but there is good news. The outreach idea on how we can reach these people is that Christians who are open to God, walking through powerful, true power encounters, could help facilitate a new understanding of the spirit world. Christians who are open to God, working through power encounters, could help facilitate new understanding of the spirit world. We are going to pray on this outreach idea that God should raise believers who are open to God's work through power, through encounters, that God will direct those people to more of the Bushi people, even to the younger generations, teaching them the ways of the Lord, teaching them about Christ, the wonders, the miracles of Jesus Christ. So this could attract them to Christ. And so we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord, for this outreach idea, Lord. Thank you for the Bushi people of Mayotte. Thank you, Lord, Masosa Taliba Kadusina Mahandaya, for even the younger generations of those people. Lord, we pray that you will raise believers, you will raise workers, laborers, oh God, who are filled with the Spirit of the Lord, who are knowledgeable in the things of the Lord, who are filled with the power of the Holy Spirit, that they will come and encounter Lord Jesus Christ. They will encounter the younger generation of the Bushi people, even the older generation, teaching them the ways of the Lord, showing them the miracles, the things that Christ can do to save them, even from their fears, from their old worship, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we pray, oh God, that you will raise believers, oh God, workers, oh God, who are filled with the Spirit of the Lord. Le pasuka palia, Holy Spirit filled workers of the Lord. Le suka palika dayabada, that they will visit, oh Lord, this people group, the Bushi people of Mayotte, oh God, teaching them the ways of the Lord. Le pasuka palia, we pray, oh God, that even as they help them, Lord, with their spiritual needs, oh God, le koto sika palia, they will come to encounter the miracles of Jesus. They will come to encounter the love of Christ, the power of the Holy Spirit, oh God, that will release them from their fears, release them from their negative spirit worship, oh God. They will come to encounter the one and only true God, and they will surrender to him in the name of Jesus. Amen. Le pasosa kaliba da da da. We pray, oh God, that as they encounter your power, Holy Spirit, they will come, oh God, to depend on you for their everyday needs. They will come to depend on you, oh God, in time of crisis, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we pray, oh God, for the believers that you are raising, oh God, to visit those people, Lord, to come in encounter, Lord, with the Bushi people of Mayotte in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray, oh God, that they will come to experience the miracle of Jesus. They will come to experience the power of the Holy Spirit, the resurrection power of Christ. And they will come to know, oh God, that you alone can save them. They will depend on you, oh God, in time of need. They will depend on you in time of crisis. They will depend on you for all their everyday needs, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, I'll give you all the praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Our scripture focus for tonight is taken from Haggai chapter 1 and verse 7. Haggai 1 and verse 7. And it says, "Thus says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. Thus says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways." With the scripture focus, we are going to pray that this people group will consider their ways and turn to the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Haggai chapter 1 and verse 7. We pray over that this people group, as they come to learn of you, as they come in contact with your word and with the truth of the Holy Spirit, with the truth of the Savior Jesus Christ, Lord, they will consider their ways in the name of Jesus. They will consider their ways and they will turn to the Lord. As these people, Lord, have an encounter with you, as they come to the knowledge and the truth about Christ, oh God, Father, they will consider their ways and they will turn to the Lord in the name of Jesus. They will consider their ways and they will embrace the salvation of Jesus. They will embrace the righteousness of Christ in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Lasso sata liba kadosete lebra dosi kapa liba handa maso sata rabado shatalia handa. Father, we pray, O God, standing upon your word in Haggai 1 and verse 7, we pray, O God, that your word will get to those people. They will receive it, O God, in their heart, O God. They will consider their ways and they will turn to the Lord. They will receive the gospel of Jesus. They will embrace the salvation, the eternal life that Jesus brings, O God. Leso kapa liba kadaya. thereby considering their ways, O God, and turning to the Lord and accepting Jesus, the one and only true God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, we give you all the praise. Thank you, Lord. For as many of those people, Lord, that are turning to the Lord right now, we say thank you, Lord. For bringing them to the knowledge of your truth, oh God, causing them to consider their ways and to turn to the Lord. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Abba Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Next, we're going to pray. Few follow Jesus today among the Bushi people. So we are going to pray that they will find each other and meet together for encouragement and instruction in the faith, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying that the few people who follow Jesus among the Bushi people today, they will find each other and they will encourage each other in the Lord. They will encourage each other in instructions in the faith, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we pray, oh God, maso kata liba kadada do seteria handa. We pray for the few believers among those people, Lord. We ask, oh God, that they will find one another. Oh, maseke riba kadada da da. They will find each other, Lord. They will meet together, Lord. Le kotosika palia handa. And they will encourage one another in the faith. They will walk together in righteousness, in the name of Jesus. They will live together in peace, oh God. Le to seek a palia handa, encouraging and empowering, helping one another in the faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. That's all, Lord. The life of Christ, the love of Christ will be seen and experienced through them, Lord. And through their lives, God, many more will draw to the Lord. Many more will turn to righteousness, even from their families, from their friends, and across their communities, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, we pray for the few, oh God, who follow Christ among the Bushi people today, that they will find one another. They will encourage each other in the Lord. They will work together, oh God, to sit in the faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We pray that the life of Christ, the love of Christ will be seen and experienced through them, Lord, and their life, oh God, will draw many more to Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Maso kalado sekeli ahanda leba do sekeri baba do sekeke masu papa liba handa da leso pali handa. Strengthen them, Lord, in the faith. Empower them, Lord, in the spirit, in the name of Jesus. Help them, Lord, to locate one another. Lepa kasu sekeli ahanda masu koko liba kadea. They will meet with each other. They will encourage one another. They will walk and instruct each other in the faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We pray over that you would raise, even Lord, a family movement of Christ among those people, Lord, that they will begin to spread the word of the Lord from family to family, from family to family, that they will begin to draw closer to God, oh God, to the word of the Lord, spread across their community, spread across the Bushi community, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, we give you praise, oh Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those people that you are empowering right now. Thank you, Lord, for you are helping them by your spirit to locate one another. Oh, my sake, riba kada do sekere. Thank you for helping them, Lord, daily, and that encourage themselves, oh God, and to stay strong in the faith, in the name of Jesus. For all you are drawing to Christ through their life, Father, we say thank you. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. In Jesus' precious name, we'll pray. Amen and amen. Amen. We're going to pray that the Lord will set the people free from chains, spirit, and lead them into a movement to Christ, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we pray, oh God, that you will set these people free, oh God, from the chains, spirit, oh Lord, from every evil, negative spirit that they've run to over the time of crisis and time of need. Lord, we pray that you will set them free from the spirit, Lord. You will lead them, Lord, to Christ, in the name of Jesus. You will draw them to yourself, oh Lord. That they will come to experience the freedom, the liberty over in Christ, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we pray by the power of the Holy Ghost that they call those, that those people are set free, Lord, that they are free from the djinns spirit, oh Lord. We pray for a movement to Christ among this people group, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we pray, Lord, that by your word and by your spirit, Lord, you will set those people free. You will set the Bushi people of Mayotte free from the djinns spirits in the name of Jesus, that they will come to depend on you. They will come to depend on the Holy Spirit for help. Oh, Masikide, in time of need, in time of crisis, they will depend on you, oh God. We pray that you will lead them, Lord, into a movement to Christ in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, we worship you. Father, we thank you for a movement to Christ among those people, Lord. Thank you for setting those people free from every djinn spirit, Lord. Thank you for filling them instead with the Spirit of the Lord, with the Spirit of the Holy Ghost, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. Blessed be your name, God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And so we're praying right now for the missionaries, the evangelists, the food soldier, everyone that have taken the gospel to this people group, to every other people, unreached people across the nations, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Father, we commit the missionaries, the evangelists, the preachers, the food soldier, everyone taking the gospel to the ends of the earth. Father, we commit them into your hands, Lord. We pray that you will going to empower them by the Spirit, O God. You will going to fill them with your word, with the right word for each and every man, O God. We pray that you will empower them, O God, by the Spirit of the Lord, that every word that they speak, O Lord, will be effective to the salvation of the souls of many across the nations, of many to whom, oh God, they speak your word to, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we pray that when they speak, oh God, the people will hear you. They will hear you and they will receive your word. They will believe it and they will turn to Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Oh, Masike Riba Kadadada, Lepa Suka Paliba Hadaya, we pray, oh God, that you will raise men, you will raise people, oh God, who will support, oh God, the spread of the gospel, even with their finances, with their talents, with all that they have, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We pray, oh God, Masuka Kaliba Dayadada, that you will raise them, Lord, even in their numbers, in the mighty name of Jesus, for even for the translation of the Bible into various languages, oh God. Even to the Bushi language, oh God, that those people will have the gospel, Lord, in their own language. They will come to learn of you in their language, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Father, we pray, oh God, Masosa Kaliba Dadada, for even the youths and the children of our generations, oh God. We pray, oh God, that those ones, oh God, they will know the Lord for themselves, oh God. They will serve him with understanding. They will walk in righteousness and the truth. Oh, Father, we pray that the heralds of our time will not have our children, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, but they will walk in the Spirit, oh Lord, and they will become great influencers of the gospel, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, I will pray for the every intercessor in the house for joy in Zoe intercessory prayer ministries. We pray for the intercessors, for all that are joining now that will still join later, oh God. Father, we pray that you will empower them by the Spirit, oh God, the grace to keep standing in the gap, to pray tirelessly, Lord, for the unreached souls. Let it be released upon them, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I will pray that you will raise even more intercessors from this altar, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. People who will not, oh God, stop keeping the word, O God, who will not stop speaking the word, making mention of those people group to the Lord. Father, you will raise them, Lord, even in their numbers, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we give you praise, O God. Awesome God, we worship you. Blessed, blessed, blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. All right, family, thank you very much. Thank you for joining in tonight's prayer. Don't forget, this prayer continues tomorrow, 9 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. Do well to invite your friends and your family to be a part of this program, knowing that as you're doing this, you're doing the will of the Father, and the Lord bless you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Have a wonderful night, rest. Shalom, shalom.